Good morning, church. Before we begin, we want to extend our apology for starting late. We are Christians. We have to be patient. It's one of the fruit of us, God's Spirit. We are having a technology problem this morning, but thank God, the Rocky has got all these ideas. So please bear with us today. But we believe and hope that you are connected with us wherever you are at. And I believe that it's only your Facebook on this particular time, not the YouTube. So go on Facebook. If you are on YouTube and Facebook at the same time, just turn off your YouTube and get connected to Facebook. May God bless us all as we begin our service. That being said, I have a couple of announcements to share with you, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. Next week on February 17th at 6:30, we are going to have our Ash Wednesday worship service. It will be in person and online at the same time. For those who are going to watch online, we are going to use cooking oil, and those who are going to be in person, we are going to use our ashes. However, if you don't, you want to use ashes at home, please give me a call, send me an email. We can meet at the church on Tuesday or even Wednesday before noon. I can give it to you. You go back with it home, and when we do the service later on, you can use it at home. And this year, 2021. In terms of our fasting and prayer, because we do understand that when we start our journey, the lengthened journey for 40 days, we are asked by God to go through fasting and prayer. But this day and this year, our fasting and prayer is going to be different. I know some when we talk about fasting, we do we kind of disconnect ourselves from something. But this time, we want to connect to each other. We want you to connect to your friend. We want you to connect to your old friend you knew maybe 40 years ago. We want you to connect to your grandchildren, your children. We want you to connect to your church members. Use the directory book you have at home. So each day, you call someone. Each day, for 40 days, it's going to be an assignment to all of us. Let's see if we are the church, and we call ourselves that we are a church. So let's be together in this journey. 40 days, you have 40 people listed. Take your paper somewhere, start writing down. You write the name of Pastor Eric. I call Pastor Eric. You just go on. And when you call the person, you share with that person the word of God, a prayer, or in the morning devotion that you read before. Share with your friend. It will take maybe 2 or 5 minutes to do that. So let's fast together. Our fasting this year, 2021, is a calling for all of us to get connected to each other. Amen? And we started our Bible study last week. The place is still empty. We need people to join us for Bible study. You are not too late. We just started with chapter 1, so we have plenty of chapters to look into. So if you feel like you want to join our Bible studies, please come on Thursday in person and online. Thursday at 6 o'clock. And if you need a book, you can contact me or Pastor Nancy, who will give you a book. And Tangent Group, they are going to kick off their new book on February 24th, that means after next week, on Wednesday. And they meet from 7 o'clock to 8:15. And if you need more information, you can even contact me. I'll give you the number of Adam Tank, and he's the leader for the Tangent Group. So may God bless you. May God bless us all as we begin our service together. I'm going to invite you to stand up and let us really go to worship. Those who are online, they can also stand if you are able. Let us read our call to worship together. Fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, love your enemies, do good to them. Then your reward will be great. Thank you. You may be seated. Friend, because today is Valentine, I know it's about love. I love when I move around Lansing, different shops. You even see the color. When you go to Maya, it's red and all things. So it's a big day to talk about love. But today, God is going to speak to us also about love. But before we do that, I want to celebrate with you as a church together. You know, God has been so good to us. God loves us so much. And you don't have even to avoid that. He loves you. He loves us so much, despite of what we have been going through. But the love of God was highly recognized in our lives. Waking up in the morning, it's just by God's love and grace. And last year, God blessed us, despite of the COVID pandemic, God has been so good. So good. So we want to celebrate the goodness of God, the love of God that God did last year in 2021 with the babies. You know, God brought babies in our church families. God has been so good. Some of us were just hiding with COVID, but God has been sending us babies. And by the way, I called them, I said, COVID-19 babies. God has blessed us. So I'm going to share that video with you. We did as a church, we collected pictures of babies. I want you to celebrate. If you have never seen the goodness of God last year, I want you to see how God has been so good to you and to me by sending these babies. I want you to see the pictures. Watch. God has been so good. That being said, I'm going to invite you to pray. Let us also pray. Bless God with all these babies. Let us pray for all these babies, for God to bless them. And let us also pray for our nation. Let us pray for ourselves. Let us pray also for our brothers and sisters who are struggling with COVID, or any disease and sickness and cancer. Let us pray. Shall we pray in Jesus' name? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, eternal God, holy and living God, we present ourselves before your throne of grace this morning, wherever we are at right now, Lord, to thank you and to bless you, God, for everything you have done in our lives. First and foremost, Father, as a church, we say thank you for all the angels you did send unto us last year, 2020. We have seen your love, your greatness, Lord, your grace and your righteousness, your presence into our lives. Father, thank you for all the babies. I pray in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, Lord, for blessings upon their lives, Lord. I pray for wisdom upon their lives. I pray for strength in the life of their parents, Lord, to help this kid, these babies, these children, Lord, to grow with godly characters for the sake of your glory in Jesus' name. Glory, hallelujah. We believe in you, Christ the Lord, who sent these babies unto us, knowing and believing, Christ the Lord, you're going to walk with them daily as they are going to be, Father Lord, your vessels into this world in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord. Blessed is your name, God, knowing and believing, Christ the Lord, you are before them. Father, we lift up, Almighty God, our nations before you. We pray in Jesus' name for mercy. We pray for your spirit. We pray, God, for revival. We pray that, Lord Jesus Christ, for your power to be revealed in the name of Jesus Christ. Eternal God, we lift up, Almighty God, the church before your throne of grace. We speak, Lord, by your spirit. Help us, O God, as a church to do ministry, Lord. Use us, Lord, for the sake of your glory. You are so powerful. That's why, Christ the Lord, you have spoken to the disciples and said, if you do not worship me, I will order stones to worship me, Lord. Hallelujah. Use us, Lord. We are here, God, as your vessels. Use us, Lord, to make disciples for the sake of your glory into this world in Jesus' name. Bless each and every child of yours. Bless them, Lord. Hallelujah. Hear their prayers. Hear their cries. Meet their needs. Financial need, spiritual need, intellectual need. Father, every need, Lord, hallelujah, must be met by you, Christ the Lord, in Jesus' name. May you, Father, Lord, be before us as we serve you and serve your people in this community and beyond in the name of Jesus Christ. Eternal God, we pray that, Lord, for our service this morning. We ask God your spirit to be with us, to speak through us, O Lord, to worship with us, to touch us, to heal us, restore us in Jesus' name. As the word says, O Lord, unto us, you say those who spend time with you, they are not wasting it. Father, do not allow us to leave this place the same way we came back, or we get connected wherever we are, Lord. Help us, O God, to be changed, to be blessed, to be transformed, to be healed by the power of your word, the power of your spirit, the power of your presence within our lives in Jesus' name. Thank you, Jehovah. We bless you. We worship you, Joshua HaMashiach. Glory to Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We humble ourselves, knowing Christ the Lord, without you, we are nothing. Thank you, Jesus. May you bless us, O God. You bless us, O God. You bless us today with your love. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, God, and we honor you. In Jesus' name, we pray together and we say amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer together. The word will be on the screen in English. And shall we pray in Jesus' name? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. But I invite Mark to give us a special song.
Happy Valentine's Day. Today's the day that we celebrate love, our love for our sweethearts, and as we gather here for worship, our love for God, and more importantly, God's love for us. In the New Testament, you may be familiar with the Greek word that we use for love, agape. It's a beautiful word. But I have another word that comes from Scripture. It comes from the Old Testament. It comes from the Hebrew word chesed. chesed. That doesn't sound very attractive, does it? But this word is just incredible. It's very difficult to translate. Sometimes it's translated steadfast love or loving kindness. We really can't get a handle on it in English. The best way I can describe this love is it's a love that loves and loves and keeps on loving, and just when you think it can't possibly continue, it loves some more. This last month, Pastor Eric has been sharing with us the 23rd Psalm. And this word chesed appears in that psalm at the end, where David celebrates the glorious truth that God's goodness and mercy will follow him all the days of his life. That word mercy is a translation of chesed. God's chesed follows me all the days of my life. Now, that word follow, that's way too weak to describe the Hebrew word behind that. A more literal translation would be that God's love and mercy, or goodness and mercy, chases me, pursues me. At the end of our service, we're going to be singing a song, O Love That Will Not Let Me Go. That's the kind of love that chesed describes. Today we're going to celebrate that love as Natalia and I share with you the classic song, Great is Thy Faithfulness. Thank you.
to Natalia. God bless us. That's a gift. Mark can sing, Mark can preach, Mark can play well. Oh my goodness. Praise the Lord. We thank God for the gift that God seated in your life. May God bless you. May God bless the church. All right, brothers and sisters in Christ, we are going to hear the word of God together. As you may be aware that today is a Valentine, and Mark prayer that did just give us a special music on love, and I'm going to preach about love, and it's a big day to talk about love deeply, so that we fully understand what God has for us. So before we begin, let me pray. Dear God, Holy and Living Father, again and again I thank you for this opportunity you have given unto me to stand before your children. Lord, I'm nothing without you, God. I pray for your Holy Spirit, Lord, to open our eyes to see and our heart to receive your word. God, as I stand before your children, may you be increased as I decrease for the sake of your glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, let us read our first reading this morning. Actually, our main reading is coming from the Old Testament. The Old Testament, the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 10. Verses 1 to 5. Hey, well, we shall read. In the course of time, the king of the Ammonites died, and his son Hanun succeeded him as king. David thought, I will show kindness to Hanun, son of Nashal, just as his father showed kindness to me. So David sent a delegation to express the sympathy to Hanun concerning his father. When David's men came to the land of the Ammonites, the Ammonites' commander said to Hanun, their lord, do you think David is honoring your father by sending envoys to you to express sympathy? Is it David sent them to you only to explore the city and spy it out and overthrow it? So Hanun seized David an envoy, shave off half of each man's beard, cut off their garments of the butt locks, and send them away. Wow, this guy was just doing good as a king. Then David was told about this. He sent messages to meet the men, for they were greatly humiliated. The king said, stay at Jericho until your beard get grown, and then come back. Wow. Praise the Lord. Even when I was reading the story, when God gave me, because I was praying the whole weekend, say, Lord, give me a word about love. We talk about love so many times. And the word love has been used in so many venues. Sometimes we say, I love food. We say, I love my children. I love my wife. I love this music. So love have been used in different ways. And I was asking the Lord, and said, God, help me. Help me to share your word about love. And the Lord has given me this story. So fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, today I'm going to preach to you on the message, the love of God. Love like you have never been hurt. The love of God. And love like you have never been hurt. Especially when you are offended. Especially when you are hurt doing what the king told you to do. In our reading, the book of 2 Samuel, we hear about this servant who were in the perfect will of God, but they were attacked. They done wrong. They were offended. They were hurt. They were humiliated and embarrassed. You know, this reminded me about this guy. I've got that picture on the screen. They remind me of this guy, Muhammad Ali. You know Muhammad Ali? Muhammad Ali, the great boxer, got on an airplane. The story that I heard, he got on an airplane. He was flying somewhere in a public airplane. And the stewardess noticed that he did not have his seat belt together. And she said to Mr. Ali, "Please, Mr. Ali, fasten your seat belt because the plane is about to take off." And Mr. Ali looked up with a smile on his faces and said, "Superman don't need seat belt." To which the lady also looked at him and said, "Superman also do not need airplane." So please, Mr. Ali, fasten your seal belt, which you need. So the point here, my friend, I'm sharing this story, is that none of us are Superman. None of us are Wonder Woman. None of us are Spider-Man. None of us Captain America. None of us. Every one of us can be and will be offended and hurt at some point in life. But we just need to love like you have never been hurt. I don't care how spiritual you are. I don't care, my friend. I don't care how long you have been serving the Lord. It is just a matter of time. And actually, it is biblical. In the book of Luke 17, Jesus said this to the disciples. Luke 17, verses 1, Jesus said this. "It is impossible that no offenses shall come." It is impossible. It is going to happen, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. Being offended is something you are going to experience in your family, with somebody you love, in your church, with somebody you love, on your job, with somebody you care about. It is going to happen. It is not possible, according to Jesus, for you and I to escape it. It is not possible for you to have relationship with people and at some point not entering into conflict and have offense and unforgiveness spirit even set into your heart. If you allow it, it can happen. There is no way out, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. It will happen. And you know, when God was giving me this message, I feel very uplifted, my fellow brothers and sisters. And I want to encourage you to take this message today. Take it and put it even in the medicine cabinets somewhere. Put in your wallets, put it on your computer, put it somewhere. Because I fully believe it is just a matter of time before you need this little message. We'll need it. The love of God, love like you have never been hurt. You are going to get offended. You are going to get hurt in your relationship. You are going to be angry somehow. You are going to be violated by somebody you love sooner or later. Somebody is going to hurt you. It is a fact that you will be offended. And since it is biblical fact that you will be offended, we have to learn how to deal with it. Because not being offended is impossible. It's impossible. The first things I want to say to you, my fellow brothers and sisters, this. To you and myself, God will use the offenses in our lives to make us into what He wants us to be, as a matter of fact. Sometimes it takes the worst things done to you to bring out the best in you. Sometimes we need to understand that there are heights you will never reach until you pass the test of being offended and somehow getting through it with love. In other words, there are some blessings you will never reach until you pass the test of being humiliated somehow. And somehow, friend, passing through it with the love of God. I have done some research and I want to share this with you. You know, this country, New Zealand. I have the picture there, you know, the New Zealand. You know it, right? Yes, it is a home of more flightless bird than any other place in the entire world. Go and do some research, that is true. And in New Zealand, 43% of the bird cannot fly. It cannot. It is an island and the bird cannot fly there. They have little stumps, bird over there, they have little stumps for wings. And the reason that their wings are underdeveloped and never grow full wings that allow them to fly is because there is no predator on the island. In New Zealand, there are no snakes. There are no wolves. There is nothing that threaten the bird population. And since there are no dangerous animal, therefore there is no need to fly. There's no need to fly. And where there is no need to fly, you lose the ability to fly. Right? You lose it. Friend, brothers and sisters in Christ, it takes a predator to create a wing that has the desire to go higher. So you have to choose. You have to choose. It takes dangerous animals to create wing for you to run, to fly. You have to choose. You have to choose. We can just sneak around in the backyard with the chicken and the rest of our lives, and or we can mount up with wings like eagles and fly, but that can only happen with oppositions. 41% of the bird in New Zealand never develop their wings because they do not have predators. They do not have oppositions. My brothers and sisters in Christ, sometimes we just want to get rid of, I don't understand. Sometimes we just want to get rid of, I don't understand. I don't know why I have such opposition in my life. Sometimes we don't understand. You're always saying, why do I have so many enemies around me? Why do people try to hurt on my dream? Why do people try to hurt on my call? And every time I do something, people, even in my family, they criticize me. The truth is, sometimes it takes the opposition for you and me to go high. In other words, sometimes it takes some difficulties and testing moment in our lives to see the power of God and His love. Like what is happening today with this COVID-19 pandemic. It takes the opposition. Our opposition enables us to do things we could not do. Let me try to put it this way. Sometimes it takes the worst things, I said again, done to you and to me, to bring out of the best in you. That was the case of David in our reading. David had a friend, the king of Ammonites, whose name was Nahash. And Nahash died. The Bible says his son Amnon became the king and the young prince. And David, in an act of kindness, he said, I want to do something in kind. I want you to be with me. I want you to get connected with me now. I want you to picture what happened in the life of David. My fellow brothers and sisters, David said, I wanted to do something nice. Something nice. 2 Samuel chapter 10, and we are told, he said, I will show an honor by sending some people because I cannot go. In other words, David said, I send 2 ambassadors as an act of kindness. He did exactly what many presidents do. When they don't want to go somewhere, they send vice president, they send secretary. So David did the same thing. David sent 2 representatives on the kingdom of Israel to this man's funeral. And they were even not harmed. The Bible says they were not harmed. And the book of 2 Samuel, now listen to what they said, verses 3. I want you to listen to this. This is really, it says this. While they were sitting there, some of the people get into the ear of this young new king at funeral. And they whisper him saying, do you really think that they have come to show you respect? They are not here for that reason. They are checking how high the walls are. They are checking the security on the gates. They are spies. They are going to bring back an army. They are going to attack you, King. Wow. And friend, the Bible says, it was not true. It was not correct. The scripture says they were falsely accused. There was no threat by these people. If you read the story, you're going to understand it. Now listen to the king now. The king ordered this man to be taken. 2 Samuel 10, 4 to 5. And this is really so painful. The king ordered, he said, you take them away. And when they took them away, they shave half of their beard off, half of it. They shave it. And the king did totally something to humiliate them. They cut off their robes and sent them back home like a bunch of babies crying. Wow. That was really painful. These men were wounded, not physically. They were offended. They were hurt, confused, disrespected. As a mighty man going back to King David, exposed, humiliated, embarrassed. It was an offensive, and they were so hurt by it. Friend, they got hurt doing what the king told them to do. Friend, sometimes, my brothers and sisters, it is one thing if you get hurt doing something stupid, but this man did everything right. They did not deserve that. They were doing what the King David told them to do, and they got attacked and humiliated. What a story. Today, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, I'm preaching to you in this particular moment. If you live for God and seek to do His will, there will be times when you will find yourself wounded and humiliated doing God's perfect will. There will be a time. As Christians today, we have to know that there will be a time where you are going to feel that way. We are going to be wounded and humiliated because you stand for Jesus. You are not exempt from that. I love what David did now. I wanted to see what David did. When they started coming home wounded, embarrassed, humiliated, and David saw them, the king saw them. I wanted to see this. David did not let them come back that way. He did not. 2 Samuel 10, 5, it said that the king David said to go to Jericho. Say, go to Jericho. Wait until your beard grows up, the real grows back. And the king, I believe, he ordered even the dresser maker down there to fix their robes. He did not want them to come as they were humiliated. David said to them, go to Jericho. Friend, do you know what Jericho means? You are not going to believe this one. If you look the word Jericho up, it's literally translated sweet fragrance. In other words, David was saying, even though you have been wounded, even though you have been humiliated, insulted, you have been offended, hurt, I want you to go to Jericho. I want you to go to the place of sweet perfume. Go there. Go there and stay. I want you to stay sweet. That's what David was saying. I want you to stay sweet. I want you to love. Love like you have never been hurt before. Brothers and sisters in Christ, I want you to say to yourself, go to Jericho. Wherever you are at here, just say to yourself in your heart, go to Jericho. When people talk about you, go to Jericho. When they offend you, go to Jericho. When they humiliate you, go to Jericho. When they hurt you, go to Jericho. When they falsely accuse you, go to Jericho. Do not get mad. Do not get angry. Do not try to get revenge. Just go to Jericho. In other words, God is saying to us, even though you are humiliated or wounded, I don't want you to get mad. I don't want you to get angry or to get hard. I don't want you to start planning your revenge, but I want you to go to Jericho. I want you to love like you have never been hurt before. The love of God, love like you have never been hurt. They may be, friend, talking about you right now as I'm sharing this word. But I let the king fight your battle. And just love like you have never been hurt before. God knows the whole story. God knows the whole truth. And people will say all kind of things about you. But you just need to stay sweet. Stay sweet. Just love. Your bird will grow again. Your hope will grow again. Just stay sweet. Your hope will grow again. I stay sweet. My hope will grow again. Praise the Lord. Friend, I don't care what they did to you. And the hope is coming. Just stay sweet. Love like you have never been hurt. You know, sometimes you feel like you have got to defend yourself and the truth. And the best is just go to Jericho and stay sweet. And keep the right spirit and God will take care of that offense. In other words, when you love like you have never been hurt, God will restore things you have lost. God will show His glory again. It's gonna happen. I don't care, friend, if they offended you. I don't care. If that man or that woman cheated on you on your left, you don't have to get in awe, but let the Lord fight that battle for you. You just have to love. Just stop trying to defend yourself and just go to Jericho and stay sweet because your bird will grow again. Stay sweet. The king David turned to Joab and said, take the mightiest men. Just read the Bible when you go home and finish it, the story. The king David said to Joab, Joab was a mighty man, and said, take mighty men with you and go back down there and deal with those people who did this to my people. And the Bible says, Joab went down there and handled the situation. Actually did more than shaving the bird and cutting the ropes. He did more. I know it is hard to stay sweet when you are offended in the natural. We want to get in a shouting match. We want to fight and we want to defend. But the king said, go to Jericho. Calm down. Go to Jericho and love. I love Jesus Christ in this scenario. Luke 23:37. Jesus could have even done bad to the people who did bad to him, but he did not. Jesus said this, Luke 23, verse 34. Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing. Jesus decided to stay sweet. God knows how to justify his own children. And you and I have to stay sweet and keep the right spirit. The love of God, love like you have never been hurt. Brothers and sisters in Christ, you know very well that our word can blow up bridges or can heal broken hearts. You know that. Our word, stay sweet, because none of us is holy. You can be mad to someone at any time, but stay sweet. Love like you have never been hurt. I'm almost done. But I believe that this Old Testament story speaks to us today. Wherever you are at, I fully believe that this story speaks to us. We have been all wounded. We have been all hurt somehow. We have a reason why we should give up. We could give up or be mad or offended. But at some point, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, you have to say, it is time for me to love like I've never been hurt. I'm going to Jericho. God is going to take care of it. And my hope is going to grow again. And my spirit and my desire is going to grow again to serve God and to serve God people. And my God is going to build up the spirit of praise again. Hallelujah. Friend, Jesus Christ is going to restore us. Love will win every time. Love will win every time. God will fight for you and me. And Philippians chapter 3:13, it says this. I want to close my sermon with this scripture. It says this. Of course, my friend, I really do not think that I've already won it. The one thing I do, however, is to forget what is beyond me and do my best to reach what is ahead of me. In other words, Paul is encouraging us not to look at how you have been wounded, humiliated, hurt, offended, but stay sweet for what is ahead of us. Love like you have never been hurt. God has a place for you called Jericho. God has a place for you and me and called Jericho, and stay sweet. Tell to yourself this week, and say it every time, and say, it is time to love like we have never been hurt. Say it this week. Today is Valentine. When you go on, when you disconnect from the service today, say to yourself, let me stay sweet. Let me love that I've never been hurt. So God will take care of the rest. My fellow brothers and sisters in Christ, I don't know how you have been wounded and where, and you have been humiliated somewhere. But today, God is speaking to all of us, wherever you are at. We are going to pray together as we end this message. I want you to pray with me. Because one thing I do know, when we stay sweet, our bird will grow, our hope will grow again, and the praise will grow again. When we love like we have never been hurt, God's praise and God's glory will be revealed again through us. I'm going to pray with you wherever you are at. I want you just to look at in your heart deeper and this and see how you have been wounded, humiliated, and hurt. That today God is saying to us, go to Jericho and stay sweet, because the bird is going to grow. And I'm inviting some dresser maker to make again your robe. That's the power of love. Hallelujah. Let us pray together. Let us pray. Hallelujah. I want you to take your right hand and put it on your heart. I want you to take your right hand and put it on your heart. We need to love. Love will win again. Hallelujah. Pray. I'm going to pray with you, my fellow brothers and sisters. If you're watching online, then do the same. Take your right hand and put it on your heart. Hallelujah. Eternal God, holy and living, just humble myself before your throne of grace and I call unto you. Father, we thank you for your word that has been spoken unto us. Lord, I pray for my brothers and sisters who have been wounded, have been hurt, humiliated, disrespected, oh God. I pray for them. Pour out your Holy Spirit, Lord. Let your Holy Spirit increase in their lives, in their heart. Holy and living God, let your Spirit help us to love like we have never been hurt. Help us, Almighty God, as a church to love like we have never been hurt. Thank you, Jesus, for your presence. And give us the Spirit, Father God, to make us strong as we move into this world. And Jesus reminded us and said, it is impossible. It is impossible. To run away from the offense. They will come, Lord. We pray, help us, oh God, with your Spirit, oh God, to help us to stand on our feet. Whenever we come across into that situation, Lord, we are going to stay sweet with you, God. We bless you and we worship you for what you have done today in our lives, in the life of the church. In Jesus' name, we pray together and we say, amen. Thank you. May God bless you, my fellow brothers and sisters in Christ. I'm going to invite Jennifer to give us a closing song. And we are singing, our closing song is coming from the book, from the United Methodist Church hymns, page 480. Oh Lord, I will not let thee go. So, can you stand up and as we sing together?
We'll just do the first two verses.
Church, we are at the end of our service, and may God bless us as a church. This is the time I'm going to invite you with the love of God just to give as God has called you to support this ministry. Wherever you are at, you can give online, here in person. Bob Jones is over there as you go and out. You just give as God has called you. May God bless you for everything you do. This church, let us receive our blessing, our benedictions. Eternal God, as we go out, as your children are giving, holy and living, pour out your Holy Spirit out to strengthen them, Lord. The love that they've never been heard. May you bless us and use us, O God, as a church. May we go into this world to love like we've never been heard. In Jesus' name, we pray together and we say amen. May God bless you and may you go in peace. Thank you for coming.
You're on.